Hey guys, welcome back on my YouTube channel. Today I'm gonna talk about how you can manage fonts according to devices. So guys, what happens, let's say at the time of designing, we consider a screen that is iPhone XR and we use some labels, buttons or text fields, okay, with the different fonts, okay. But what is the problem here guys? Let's say we are designing at the time of designing, we are considering the XR device, but when we're testing on the different devices, like for example, for 5S, 6S, or different XX Max or XR, right? So on the basis of devices, the font is not going to be, dynamically changed. Okay, so if we want to change the font dynamically according to devices, like if I am testing on 5S, then I want to reduce the font size from two font size from the current font. Okay, so this kind of functionality we want. So how we can achieve it today, I'm gonna tell you. Okay, so for that, what I'm going to do here, guys, in the last video, we have seen how we can use custom font in our application. Okay, so here as you can see, I have imported some fonts from the internet, okay, that is Nunito font, okay, and I'm going to add these Nunito font in my info.plist file, as you can see within this fonts provided by application. So guys, if you didn't watch my last video on the custom font app, then you can watch the application right now, you can watch that video right now. I will drop the link in the video description, okay, so you can see the video how you can use the custom font in our application. By the way, let's come on the topic once again. So what is our requirement? Let me take three labels actually, so that I can show you how the font size is going to be decreases or increases according to the devices. Okay, so for that, let me take another label, right? And let me give the 40 from the bottom as the auto layout constraint, and okay, fine. So here, and let me give the center in the horizontally, and let me increase the font size as 20, and I want to give as the first label text, okay, and one more label I want, so let me copy and paste it here. So guys, now let me change the text here as a second label, okay, so you can give any, and let me give the font as 18, okay, so width font 20, okay, and width font 18, and it is 20, right, with font 22, okay. So guys, these are our labels, okay, so these are labels, and with some initial fonts. And now guys, what I want to do here, I want to manage these fonts according to devices. So for that, what I will do guys, I'm gonna create one more file that will be our util file, okay. So let me create, okay, so before creating the util file, let me create one more file that is that will be our constant file, okay, and in this constant file I'm going to define my all fonts which I'm going to use in this application, okay. So let me write the code here. So guys, I have defined all the fonts which are going to be used in our application. Okay, so as you can see, I have a Nunito font with different variants, okay. So this is our constant file where I have defined my app font. Now let me create one more file, okay, that will be our util file, or I will tell you one more thing here. first of all, let me create the util file, and here let me define the structure util with some utility methods. Okay, so guys, here as you can see, I have okay, so what is the problem here? Let me make it as float. Okay, so I did some code here, and so guys, there is a variable which I am going to use the screen type. Okay, and I can determine the screen type on the basis of height and width of the device. Okay, so for that, what I'm going to do here, guys, I'm going to create one extension here. So for that, let me create one extension. Okay, and in this extension, what I will do, let me show you, UI device extension. Okay, so you can write UI device plus extension, and in this I'm going to do some code here. So guys, this is the code which I'm going to use. So as you can see, guys, here I have a enumeration with some cases, okay, and with some values, row values, and there is a variable that is computed property. Okay, and here I'm going to use a screen type class, or you can say enumeration I'm going to use. So if my if I found any screen height as 960, then I'm going to consider it as 4 or 4S device. Okay, in the same way, there are some height of the devices, and on the basis of that, I'm going to determine which kind of device user is going to use. Okay, and there are almost multiple methods are available here. So I will upload this project on the GitHub, and I will drop the link in the video description so that you can download and you can go through this UI device extension. Okay, by the way, let me come on the topic once again. So this is our util file, and here I'm going to use this UI device dot screen type, and I'm going to check if the device screen type is like this, then I'm going to decrease the font size by 2. In the same way, there are lots of checks are available in the switch case. Okay, so this is the all about how we can determine which screen user is going to use and how we can decrease or increase the font. By the way, now guys, I want to apply this scenario here on these labels. Okay, or if you want to use the if you want to manage the font of the text field or buttons, then you can follow the same pattern which I have followed until now. Okay, now for the further step, what you will do, you will create a new a new Swift file here, and I can give the name as like label design. Okay, so I'm going to create a new class that is label design, and it is going to be child of our UI label class. So let me first of all import UI kit and label. Okay, so UI label, and here let me call a lifecycle method that is awake from nib, and here what I will do, I will make a check if my label having a tag like 1, then I can apply the font like regular with the with the appropriate font size. Okay, so for that, let me do the code and I will explain you. So guys, as you can see now, we have did some code, right? So what I am doing here, I have created a subclass of the UI label, and I'm going to take the font of the current label, right? So whoever we are going to assign this class to label, so first of all, we are going to get the font size of the current label. Okay, current font size, and we are going to apply some tag, and on the basis of tag, we are going to apply some fonts like bold, thin, regular, and we are going to get the font size according to the device here with the help of this method, and we are going to pass this updated font to these UI fonts within these UI fonts constructor. Okay, so there may be a chance if your font is one, then you will apply. So we are getting the updated font here, and first of all, what we are doing here, we are getting the current font size, and we are calculating what will be the font size for the current device, and on the basis of that, we are deciding the font for that particular label on the basis of that of the assigned tag. Okay, so now as you can see, we have a subclass of the UI label as a label design. Okay, so what I will do, I will go in the storyboard and I will assign this class to each and every label. Okay, so for that, like this. Okay, so I am going to assign like this. Okay, and now what I will do, I will assign some tags. Okay, like 1 for my first table, first label, 2 for the second label, and 3 for the third label. Okay, so in this way I have assigned the tags to all the labels, so it is the font will be going to be applied at the runtime. Okay, now guys, for the cross checking whether our font is going to be applied or not, what we can do, I'm going in the view controller and I'm going to create the outlet of these three fonts. Okay, so this is I think there is already a label. Okay, so this is our first label, and so let me create the outlet first label, and in the same way one outlet for the third label. Okay, so in this way you can define the outlet, and now here let me print a font for all these three labels. Okay, so for that, let me do first label dot font, and let me show you what will be the sizes for the different devices. Okay, and I will run this application on two simulators. Okay, so that we can observe the font size according to the devices. Okay, so first of all, let me run on the XR device. Okay, so guys, our application is up and running here. As you can see, the first one is bold, the second one is I think regular and or thin, and the third one is I think regular. Okay, let me cross check with our printed statements. Okay, so guys, as you can see, first one is the semi bold and second one is light and the third one is regular. Okay, and as you can see, for XR the font size is 23, 25 and 21. Okay, now but originally we have assigned 20, 22 and 18. Okay, so actually this font size which I have assigned, that was according to the, you know what, XR, I think iPhone 8. Okay, but for the XR it is going to increase three font sizes. Okay, from the current font size. Okay, according to our logic, so you can change the logic of the get current font size according to devices method according to you, whatever you want. Okay, now let me run it on the 5S device. Okay, a small device, and let's test what will be the font size for the 5S. Okay, and guys, as you can see, our application is almost up and running, and guys, you can see the you know what, the font sizes which has been applied is -2 from the current size. And if I run this application once again on the, you know what, XR, let me run it once again on the XR. So in the 5S it was 18, 20 and something 16 around, actually I don't remember. By the way, on the XR, as you can see, it is 23, 25 and 21. So the font is going to be managed according to the device's screen. So as you can see guys, the font is managed according to the devices, the font size, right? So guys, I would like to recommend you, whenever you are going to develop the applications, you should have to manage the font sizes of your text fields, buttons or labels. Okay, so guys, if you really like the video, if you really like my work, then kindly hit the like button. if you are having any question or if you are having any suggestion for me, then kindly comment in the comment section. And share with your friends. If you didn't subscribe my channel yet, then kindly subscribe my channel. That will be appreciation for me. Thank you for this video. I will see you in the next video.